So, I was supposed to get the 5800 X3D today, but Newegg screwed the pooch on that. But something else did come in the mail today. An Intel Celeron. Now, what could we possibly need this for? So long story short, while I was doing that DDR5 versus DDR4 video, taking the CPU out of both motherboards constantly, I actually screwed up and I put the IHS on backwards on one of them and I knocked off a couple of capacitors off because they're delidded, right? Knocked a couple off my 12900K. Now, when you, those capacitors are like microscopic, right? If you knock it off and you lose it, you ain't finding it, right? So then obviously my CPU wouldn't post anymore, right? So then I was like, holy crap, what am I gonna do? So I had a 12600K, which I haven't done any content on this yet. I had it, right, for future content. And I'm like, well, I gotta harvest the capacitors off of this. I'll post a picture up here so you guys can see it. I gotta harvest the capacitors off of this to get the other one working because that one is obviously more valuable, right? So you guys in the Discord, you've been following this whole fiasco, right? So now I'm two capacitors short on the 12600K. But it's not like I can, you know where I'm going with this, right? So my gamble with all this was I was gambling that the capacitors on this 12600K were the same as the ones on the 12900K, like the same capacitance value. Not sure if that's how you say it. The same part numbers, right? So what I don't know is if the Celeron capacitors are the same as this one. But this was the cheapest LGA 1700 CPU that I can find. I think it was like $60 from BHP, B&H or whatever. So what the plan is, I'm gonna take the capacitors off of this one, transplant them to the 12600K, and then we're gonna see if you can actually repair a bad delid job or just a mistake by buying one of these things. Now, I'm sure there is a way to like possibly knock one of these off and get the values of it and maybe order it from DigiKey or something like that. That's way beyond my skill level, so I'm just gonna like I'll order a shittier, cheaper CPU and just harvest the capacitors off of it, right? But that's the plan for today. So what we'll actually do first, let's take the 12600K here with the two missing capacitors. Let's throw it into a motherboard. And I'm pretty sure it won't post because the other one didn't, but let's kind of do a before and after to see if we can fix this thing, right? So let's go do that right now. And also, just an aside here, it also comes with a stock Intel cooler, which is just really handy to have for situations like this when you have a motherboard outside of a case, right? You can just clip this thing in and just test some stuff, right? So there is a value add there, right? In case you ever do throw some capacitors out the window. I don't know if it'll actually damage the CPU running it without the capacitors or not, but I'm willing to just do that for the content, right? But, you know, 9 times out of 10, missing capacitors won't actually damage anything. It just won't run. So let's turn it on. I'm just gonna use a stock cooler, actually. But let's turn it on and then see if we get any kind of error lights or something over here, right? Okay, let's turn it on, see what error code it gives us with those two capacitors missing. Great. This board does not have any error lights. Oh man. All right.
A few moments later.
All right, round two. I grabbed this MSI Edge board and said this one definitely has lights on it. So let's try this one more time. Okay. Yeah, this will work. So I wonder if it'll actually get off of the red CPU light here. If not, then we have a good candidate. Yeah. So just a straight up red CPU light, it won't get past it. So, okay, I just turned it off. So usually normal behavior would be it would go red, then blink orange or white, then go red again, then kind of try and post. but as it stands right now, it's not even trying to post. So, now that we have the before, I mean, I hope the CPU isn't screwed now, but let me just turn this off. Let me get my handy dandy soldering iron and let's do some surgery and see if we can't revive this 12600K with a Celeron heart transplant. Okay, so here is the Celeron. Now I'm going to do one capacitor at a time. I'm not gonna bother desoldering it. I'm just gonna rip it off with tweezers because I don't care about saving this chip, right? But I wanna grab the capacitor with tweezers and then I want to keep the position. I don't know if these are directional capacitors or not. I don't know. All I know is I wanna grab it, keep it in position, and move it over to the other CPU. That's it, okay? So that's where, so we're gonna do one at a time, okay? I'm gonna grab this one and then we're gonna put it on the other CPU. Okay, I think I got it, maybe. I might have to go back and redo this one over here. This one is nice and straight, but this one is like crooked AF, but I think the solder did make connection. I'll put a picture up here to see, show you what it looks like. But with that being said, let's throw it in the motherboard. And I mean, hell, give it a shot. Let's see if it actually posts. Moment of truth time, let's go. Come on, baby. Oh, did you see that? Did you see that? Oh, wait a minute. I don't think it's gonna post. No, I think it is crooked. Oh, no. Interesting. Yeah, I think the one on the bottom right there was, it's definitely not posting. Okay, the one on the bottom right was too crooked. I know the one on the left is fine. I gotta pull it back up and I gotta straighten that one capacitor out again. Interesting though, so if you have one on the bottom right that's knocked off, then it'll keep bouncing back and forth, it looks like, and just not post. Now another interesting thing is, one of these capacitors did work because we had a solid red light before, but now it's trying to boot loop. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this bottom right one off and try turning it on with just the one on the left, just to see that maybe the left ones are the same on the Celeron, but not the bottom ones. So I'm actually just gonna do it while it's in the socket because I don't care. All right, yeah. So the CPU definitely is not dead. Okay, so I pulled this capacitor off. Now let's turn it back on. Yeah, see? So what is that bottom right capacitor that's doing it? Yep. Okay. So it looks like, okay.
1 eternity later.
Okay, it's been about an hour. Took me a while, but I got that capacitor 100% straight. There's no way this is not gonna work now. I mean, if those capacitors are the same, this is gonna work now. So let's try this one last time and hope. Oh man. Oh no. It's not doing the blinking thing now. Nah. Oh man, no, it's just red now. Oh wait. It just turned white and turned off. Oh, no. 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 Oh, yeah, it's green. Oh, my God. It totally worked. Okay. Celeron is a... Okay, I'm going to go run upstairs and hook this up to a monitor to make sure we can get into the BIOS here. Okay, I'm about to turn it on here. So if this works, that means if you have a shiny new 12900KS and you screw up a D-Lid on it, you can fix it with one of these Celerons, I think. So let's see what happens here. We know it's going to go green, right? I think. Should go green. Come on. Watch it not. Oh, there we go. Okay. Let's go, baby. Oh! 12600K. If you like the content, hit that subscribe button. Do all that YouTube SEO stuff. Like, share, subscribe. Comment down below if you screwed up a D-Lid and you need to fix your Alder Lake chip. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Oh my God, this is so sick. Talk to you later.